Imagine that it's 1951. You live in Rosebank, a leafy section of North Baltimore, about 3 miles north of Johns Hopkins University. One Friday morning, you're at home, having your second cup of coffee, when there's a knock at the door. You open it, and a man in a black suit flashes a badge. "Hello, sir. I'm from the FBI. Mind if I come in and ask you a couple of questions about your neighbor, the biologist at the university?"
"Of course."
The two of you sit down to chat. You know your neighbor occasionally works for the government, so this all feels routine. "How long have you known him?" The agent starts off with softballs. "A couple of years. What's his family like?"
We're not particularly close, but he's respectable, quiet, keeps to himself. Teaches Sunday school at the Baptist church around the corner. In fact, his parents were missionaries. He was born in China."
"Oh, China. Does he speak Chinese?" "You don't know." But sensing an opening, the agent gets a little more aggressive. "The FBI has reason to believe that your neighbor has had contact with communist organizations. 6 years ago, it seems, he was the faculty sponsor for a student dance organized by American Youth for Democracy, which is a well-known communist front. Can you think of any other times your neighbor has associated with communists?"
"This is ridiculous. He's a staunch and loyal American citizen. He has no use whatsoever for communism or any other foreign ideology."
"Are you sure? How do you know? How can you know?" The interview ends. You show the agent out and sit back down for a few minutes to collect your thoughts. Truth be told, you don't really know your neighbor all that well. I mean, you like him, but he does sometimes express his views as slightly left of center. You remember during the war, he once asked you to sign a petition protesting segregation in the military. And in the newspapers, you've read that the civil rights movement is riddled with communists. You finish your coffee and think about your cousin's son, who's fighting the communists somewhere in the mountains of Korea. Your mind wanders a bit back to when you took your daughter to the movies last week. The newsreel before the matinee showed streams of Eastern European refugees fleeing to the West, abandoning everything for a chance at freedom. You think about mushroom clouds and the treasonous scientists who stole atomic secrets and passed them on to Stalin. You resolve to watch your neighbor more carefully. After all, the nation is at war.
From Wondery, this is American History Tellers. Our history, your story.
Hi, I'm Lindsay Graham. And no, in case you were wondering, not that Lindsay Graham. I am, though, an American, and deeply interested in our shared history. So on this show, I partnered with PhD historians to take you to the events, the times, and the people that shaped America and Americans, our values, our fights, and our dreams. We'll put you in the shoes of everyday citizens as the Cold War, the American Revolution, Prohibition, or the Gold Rush were happening. And we'll show you how history affected them, their families, and affects you now. We're starting American History Tellers with a 6-episode series about the Cold War. This is part one. There's an iconic photograph that you may have seen from 1945, near the end of the Second World War. The British, American, and Soviet leaders of the Grand Alliance, Winston Churchill, Franklin Roosevelt, and Joseph Stalin, are sitting next to each other in wooden chairs, looking chilly under their February coats. FDR sports a cape. Churchill's got his trademark cigar, and if you look closely, you can see FDR's cigarette holder. They're sitting so close to one another that their elbows almost touch, but they're each staring off in a different direction, lost in their own thoughts. There's another version of this photograph, one with a wider focus. In that one, a small army of advisors and diplomats mill around behind the three leaders. Few wear hats or topcoats, but most are bareheaded. They must have been cold. There's a set of arched doorways in the back and several Persian rugs scattered over the ground.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.